Thank you. for Blessed Mother Mary on the feast of her Assumption. Through her blessed prayers, make us worthy to rejoice with her at your right hand when we meet you in glory, and we will raise glory and thanks to you, to your Father, and to your Holy Spirit forever.
Amen.
Who in his grace dawned from Mary, who is the great East, and with his divine rays gave life to the whole world, to the hidden child, to honor the day of his mother's Assumption, and exalted her blessed memory on earth and in heaven. To the good one be glory and honor on this feast in all the days of our lives and forever. O Christ, the Word of God, and the Son of the Eternal Father, at the appointed time, you chose to take flesh and be born of the Virgin Mary, the daughter of David, and you fulfilled your plan of salvation for us. You lifted up your mother to be with you, and crowned her as Queen of Heaven and Earth. Today we honor the feast of the glorious Assumption, and with the holy apostles who gather from around the world to honor her, and with those who serve you in heaven, we cry out to her with noble melodies proclaiming, "Come in peace, O pure mother, you gave birth to God the Word and carried the heavenly King in your womb. Come in peace, O temple of the Holy Spirit, you are the dwelling place of God the Most High. Come in peace, O spiritual ladder seen by Jacob. Through you we climb the heights above the power of suffering and death. Now, O Christ our God, we ask you through her prayers and with the fragrance of this incense to grant forgiveness of sins, security to churches, and peace to monasteries and convents. Help the elderly, encourage the youth, nurture the children, and grant rest to the faithful who have drawn to you. Make us worthy to be united with your mother, the Holy Virgin Mary, and the choirs of the prophets, apostles, martyrs, and confessors in your eternal kingdom, where we will raise glory and thanks to you, to your Father, and to your Holy Spirit forever.
Thank you.
Christ our Lord, accept the fragrance of the incense that we have offered on the feast of the Assumption of your Mother, the Blessed Virgin Mary. With the holy apostles, make us worthy to honor the day of her departure from this world, and grant forgiveness to your flock that celebrates her feast. We raise glory and thanks to you, to your Father, and to your Holy Spirit forever. Adisha, Aloho, Adisha, Ayantolo, Adisha, Aloho. Adisha, Aloho, Adisha, Ayantolo, Adisha, Aloho. Adisha, Aloho, Adisha, Ayantolo, Adisha, Aloho.
Brothers and sisters, let not be sincere. Hate what is evil, hold on to what is good. Love one another with mutual affection. Anticipate one another in showing honor. Do not grow slack in zeal. Be fervent in spirit. Serve the Lord. Rejoice in hope. Endure in affliction. Persevere in prayer. Contribute to the needs of the Holy One. Exercise hospitality. Let those who persecute you, bless them, do not curse them. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Weep with those who weep. Praise be to God.
Remain silent
and listen to the Holy Gospel. about to be proclaimed to you. Listen and give glory and thanks to the word of the living God.
Mary said, my soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God, my Savior, for he has looked upon his handmaid's lowliness. Behold, from now all ages will call me blessed. The mighty one has done great things for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is from age to those who fear him. He has shown light with his arm, dispersed the arrogant with mind and heart. He has thrown down the rulers from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. The hungry he has filled with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has helped Israel, his servant, remembering his mercy, according to his promise to our fathers, to Abraham, and to his descendants forever. Shinoa Shalom Kutku.
Praise and blessings to Jesus Christ, our Lord and God, for giving us his words of
life. In the Father, and the Father, and the Holy Spirit, one true God, amen. Sometimes, on Ephesians 3, sometimes that makes sense whenever a piece lines up in a certain way. And there's a beautiful kind of bizarre comparison to what I was kind of talking about last week for the Feast of Transfiguration, which was coming up today and in at least a month's time. So last week I kept talking about this ascent of humanity to divine, this natural or supernatural inclination of the human heart to reach up for God, to be lifted up and to be with them in heaven's heights, and how they would come up to mountains to praise God, and temples were built on the tops of mountains and things like that. And then today we celebrate the feast of the Assumption, or Dormition of the Mother of God, when the Blessed Mother of our Lord, Jesus Christ, died. And all of the apostles came from around the world to transfer a beautiful funeral and lay her in the tomb. And after 3 days' time, they went to see the tomb in which she had been raised up by her son to be in heaven. And throughout the Bible, the church fathers, and you heard it in the historia for today, you have this idea about the spiritual ladder seen by Jacob. Well, I hope you know the story, but if not, this comes down to us from the 28th chapter of the book of Genesis. Whenever Jacob, the son of Abraham, had gotten into a tussle with his brother Esau, and Esau had found this favor with God, and Jacob was granted favor by God, and so Esau was going to kill his brother, like other people do, I suppose. And so Jacob fled. He fled from his family's home and escaped his brother Esau. And so he was on his way to Haran, and he ended up in the city of Bethel, which is a Canaanite town in the region. And Canaanites were not Jews, but they did have a devotion to the one God, even if they didn't fully understand exactly who it was. And so he was in Bethel, which, what does Bethel mean? What does Beth mean? Bethlehem, so Beth. Beit Marun, come on, a lot of Hebrew, Syriac, Arabic. Beit, does Beit mean in there? House. So what does El mean? Yes, good, there we go, good. The house of God. And so even though Canaanite town of Bethel was not a Jewish town, they had venerated God, so they built a ziggurat, a temple, in the town, dedicated to what they conceived as God, and that was their dwelling place that they had there. And Jacob came into this town, and while he was there, he fell asleep, because he was running from his brother who had been trying to murder him, and so he was probably pretty tired. He passed out and had a little bit of a vision while he was there. So this is what this little passage from the chapter says. Jacob left Beersheba and went toward Haran, and he came to a certain place. stayed there that night when the sun had set. Taking one of the stones of the place, he put it under his head and lay down in that place to sleep. And he dreamed that there was a ladder set up on the earth, and the top of it reached to heaven. And behold, the angels of God were ascending and descending on it. And behold, the Lord stood above it, and said, I am the Lord, the God of Abraham your father, and the God of Isaac, the land on which you lie, I will give to you and your descendants. And your descendants shall be like the dust of the earth, and you shall spread abroad to the west and the east and the north and the south, and by you and your descendants shall all families of the earth bless themselves. Behold, I am with you, and will keep you wherever you go, and will bring you back to this land, for I will not leave you until I have done that of which I have spoken to you. Then Jacob awoke from his sleep and said, surely the Lord is in this place, and I do not know it. And he was afraid and said, how awesome is this place! This is none other than the house of God, and this is the gate of heaven. And so, naturally, here, in the literal sense, we see Jacob leading the Israelite people, the Hebrew people, the Hebrew Israel. So, leaving the house of his father and grandfather and going to this Canaanite village and seeing there that this indeed was the worship of God. Even if they did not fully understand who they were worshiping and weren't exactly corresponding with that chosen people of God. But the Lord says it still has made itself there. And so God gave him a vision and a foreshadowing that even though the people of Israel, his descendants, would encircle the earth with their descendants, that the worship of God would expand to all people. And that's why in the gospel there is that all ages will call me blessed. And not just those few of the chosen house of Israel, but the whole earth and all of its inhabitants will praise the one true God and his promise to give to Jacob here in Bethel. And what's beautiful about this idea that we associate Mary with this ladder that Jacob had seen in his dream, because through Mary we see this descent of God and the ascent of humanity. Through Mary's yes, replacing the no of Eve, God chose through Mary to descend from his dwelling place on high to earth, and to her a ladder by which God climbed down from the heights, he was able to dwell with us, to indeed bring that dwelling place of God here on earth within the world. And Mary herself became that beautiful temple, that dwelling place, that house of God, that Bethel. In herself, she became that dwelling place of God. But also, we hear the latter ascent. And so we see the day that she died, she was laid in the tomb, that her son did not see his mother go to decay. And so he raised her from death, and assumed her into heaven, that ascent of the body and soul of his beloved mother into the dwelling of heaven. And because she suffered a death like we do, and she was resurrected like we are promised to be raised, and ascended to sit at the right hand of her son, we are given hope. Adam and Eve's no was replaced by the yes and the love of the new Eve and the new Adam, Mary and her beloved son, Jesus. And through their acts here on earth, and the acts of the Godhead with her, we are given that promise, that foretaste of the resurrection, that hope that he would take his mother from the grip of death and raise her on high. But we have that same hope, that he would not forget us, just as he remembered his own mother. And so we have hope that not only God would descend to dwell with us, that we could be able to ascend through that ladder of his mother that promises the resurrection to be raised on high. And the only reason that when Mary died, she was not abandoned abandoned death, was because of the feast that we'll celebrate in 1 month's time, the feast of the exaltation of the cross, our Lord choosing to ascend on Mount Golgotha, to be raised on the cross and to die so that he might be raised on the third day and grant us eternal life. And so all of these things have a coherence, because when he says that in the Gospels, that whenever I am lifted up, I will draw all people to myself. And that is what happens in these great mysteries of salvation. The mystery of the transfiguration, you're drawn up into the mystery of his divine life, him revealing himself to us. In the mystery of the dormition and assumption of his mother, Christ invites us and promises us this hope of the resurrection for ourselves. We might not be abandoned to death, but like his beloved family members, like his mother, we too are his brothers and sisters, will be raised up into heaven's heights on that ladder seen by Jacob in Genesis. And then the mystery of the cross, that he, when he was raised up in death, all mankind, all creation, all the universe was drawn into him. And that is how we are able to ascend on high. He lowered himself to the lowest point of death, but in doing so, he was raised up on the cross and raised up from death and ascended on high. So all of these beautiful, beautiful feasts we celebrate, all come into one another in these great mysteries of the descent of God to us and our ascent to heaven to dwell with him. As we commemorate the death and the assumption of the Mother of God, let us invoke her intercession as his mighty fortress of protection for us, that we might always hope in the resurrection, and that under her mantle we will always be dead. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and of the true God. Amen. The Holy Mother of God, pray for us. We believe in one God.
All things visible and invisible. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ,
the only God, the Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, right through life, through God, and through God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and the grave, and he was given on the third day according to the scriptures. Concerning the heaven, and seated at the right hand of the Father, he will come again in glory and judge the living and the dead, and he will have dominion. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord of the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, and the Father and the Son is the glory of the Lord. Has spoken to the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and we look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Thank you. offerings of our ancestors, now accept these offerings that your children have brought to you. Out of their love for you and for your holy name, shower your spiritual blessings upon them, and in place of their earthly gifts, grant them life and your kingdom.
Amen.
As we remember our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ and his plan of salvation for us, we recall upon this offering all those who have pleased God from Adam to this day, especially Mary, the Blessed Mother of God, on this day for her holy ormission, Saint Marin and Saint George. Remember, O God, the children of the Holy Church, our fathers and mothers, and our brothers and sisters, both the living and the departed, especially those for whom this sacrifice is offered, for your servant Bernard. Remember also all those who share with us today in this offering. Lord God and Father, you are true love, security that is ever sure and hope that never fails. Grant love, happiness, and everlasting peace to your children here before you. Make us worthy to give one another the greeting of peace with your hearts and souls, and with a holy kiss worthy of your blessed name, that we may raise glory to you, to your only Son, and to your Holy Spirit, now and forever. Shlomo l'mad b'chol dalobo, v'shlomo rose kadishe skimin, shlomo v'shem shlomo v'chol.
Let us give the greeting of peace to our neighbor with love and faith that are pleasing to God.
O Lord, as we bow before your majesty, send us your grace and glorious blessings from the heights of your heavenly sanctuary, that we may glorify you, your only Son, and your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
O Lord, you sent your beloved Son at the appointed time for our salvation, and he gave us these holy and life-giving mysteries. Do not look upon us as strangers, and do not turn your face away from us because of our many sins. For you alone are the Holy One, with your only Son and your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
The love of God the Father, and the grace of the only begotten Son, and the communion and indwelling of the Holy Spirit be with you, my brothers and sisters, forever.
And with your spirit.
Let us lift up our thoughts, our minds, and our hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord with reverence and worship and with humility.
It is right
and just to praise you, O Lord of all in heaven and on earth. The powers on high in the heavens where they dwell glorify you. The fiery rays exalt you. The cherubim bless you and the seraphim worship you. They cry out and proclaim.
Thank you.
sagie, metet se omenti hed, nobosor haube varvai, that all and all me. O cano el posso danzig woman harum in my row, we are till me thou caro, savish thou me near for food. O no, then be thou, O dear, dear, think of the food. The hello, fai kun, wahalo sagi, make the shed woman be heard. No soul how be will find that all and all me. Do this in memory of me, for whenever you eat this body and drink this blood, you proclaim my death until I come again. O Christ our God, we remember your plan of salvation, and we implore your goodness when you come in glory with your holy angels and all await the reward they deserve. And when you place the sheep to the right and the goats to the left, do not look upon us as strangers to your household, and do not turn your face away from us. Do not let our sins and offenses touch your holy heart, and do not separate us from you, for we have professed your holy name and have proclaimed your divinity. Rather, treat us according to your promises. Forgive our sins, pardon us, and have mercy on your inheritance. For this your repentant church implores you, and through you and with you implores your Father, saying, O Lord, as we are poor and sinful servants, receive your graces. We thank you for them and because of them.
How awesome is this moment, my beloved, for the living Holy Spirit descends and rests upon this offering for our sanctification. Let us stand with reverence as we pray.
May these holy mysteries sanctify the bodies and souls of those who share in them, cleanse their hearts, purify their thoughts, and be a pledge of the heavenly kingdom and new life forever. O Lord, we now remember in the sacrifice all the holy churches and the shepherds of the true faith, especially Francis the Pope of Rome, Bishara Peter, our Patriarch of Antioch, Gregory, our Bishop, and all bishops. With them, remember the priests, the deacons, and all who serve your church. We pray to you, O Lord.
For the peace and stability of the whole world, for blessed and prosperous years, for an abundant heart, for the sick and the oppressed, for all who call upon your holy name on the land, here in the air, and who profess that you are the true God, we pray to you, O Lord. Remember, O Lord, those who have presented your offering upon this altar, and those who desire to do so before your name, and grant them their petitions, we pray to you, O Lord. Remember all things, Father, Prophet, Apostle, Lord, and Christ, Mary, Mother, God, St. George, and St. Mary, and all the righteous of God. To their prayers, may God's word to stand among them. We pray to you, O Lord.
Remember, O Lord, in your grace, those who have left us and have gone to you from the first Christian disciples to this day. They were signed with the seal of baptism and receive the precious body and blood of your Son. They await for you in your life-giving hope. Raise them up on the last day, and in your mercy forgive their sins. To our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, who is without sin, we hope to find mercy and forgiveness for our sins and for theirs. Grant us pardon, O God, and forgive us and the departed, so that your blessed name may be glorified in us and in all things. With the name of our Lord Jesus Christ and of your living Holy Spirit, now and forever. You taught us through your beloved Son. We stand before you and call upon you with your souls and clear consciences, praying. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Deliver us, O Lord, from every temptation and from the harm of evil. For you have power over all, and we raise glory to you now and forever. Peace be with you.
Amen. bow your heads before the God of mercy, before his forgiving altar, and before the body and blood of our Savior, who gives life to those who partake of him and receive a blessing from the Lord.
O Lord, in your grace and abundant mercy, bless those who bow before you, make us worthy to share in your life-giving mysteries and to join the assembly of your saints, that with them we may raise glory to you, to your only Son, and to your Holy Spirit, now and forever. Grace of the Holy, Eternal, Everlasting, Uncreated, and Consubstantial Trinity be with you all, my brothers and sisters, forever.
Let each one of us look to God with reverence and humility, and ask him for mercy and compassion.
The Holy, for the Holy, with perfection, purity, and sanctity.
Amen.